how to solve physics problem easily or how to solve physics numericals easily. Before starting the lecture, click on the subscribe button and get access to our 100 of conceptual lectures for free. Firstly, let me tell you that why should you watch this video? We know that there are 100 of videos available on this same keyword and YouTube. I will say that they all are copying and pasting each other. Only few people or teachers are honestly sharing their practical experience which really work. So I am also going to share my personal two techniques or two tricks which I haven't learned from anyone, and believe me, neither I am going to copy someone nor am I going to teach you something which haven't produced results for myself. Believe me, after watching this video, you will start looking to your physics numericals from a very different angle. Are you ready to learn these magical tricks or magical techniques? Okay, let me tell you, I am not teaching you 10 rules or 20 powerful rules, etc. I am just teaching you only two very simple tricks or two very simple techniques through which you can crack or solve any numerical or problems of physics in minutes. And I will show you practically how I personally use these two techniques or these two tricks. The first technique or trick which I personally call is concept formula trick or technique. And the second technique or trick is brute force trick or technique. Believe me that these two techniques have produced stunning results not only for me but also for my 100 of students. Now, how to use concept formula trick or technique to solve physics problems or physics numericals? We can only use this concept formula trick on numericals in which we are sure about the concept and we know about its formula. For example, find speed, find velocity, calculate force, etc. In such type of numericals or problems, we know about the concept of speed, velocity, and force, etc. And we already know exactly about their respective formulas. So in such type of physics problems, we can use concept formula trick or technique. Now, how I personally use this concept formula trick and how you can use it, let me give you an example. Let's consider that a runner makes one round trip around a 360 meter circular track in 30 seconds. What is his average speed and what is his average velocity? Now, firstly, I read it for given data and highlight it. For example, one round trip. It means that initial and final position of the runner would be the same. Secondly, 360 meter track. It means the runner covers 360 meter distance S. Thirdly, and time T is equal to 30 seconds. After highlighting the given data, I look for the required variable or variables. For example, here, what is his average speed? So we have to find average speed V, or average speed is required. Secondly, what is his average velocity? So we also need to find average velocity V arrow. Here, there are two concepts. Average speed and average velocity. What are their respective formulas? We know that average speed is equal to total distance upon total time, or V is equal to S upon time. Here, the total distance S is equal to 360 meter and the total time taken by the runner is 30 seconds. Hence, the average speed 360 meter divided by 30 seconds is equal to 12 meter per second. Now, what about the average velocity? We know that average velocity is equal to total displacement upon total time taken. Here, a lot of students do a blunder. They will solve this as V arrow is equal to total distance S arrow is equal to 360 meter upon total time taken T is equal to 30 seconds. But this is wrong. Here, the initial position and the final position of the runner is same. Hence, its average displacement is zero. When average displacement is zero, average velocity becomes zero. Therefore, I call this technique concept formula technique. You must know the respective concept of any topic and also the respective formula of that topic. This is a false myth that physics numericals are physics problems check your calculating skills only. In reality, they check your both concepts and calculating skills. I hope that you have learned the first concept formula technique or trick. But it has some limitations. For example, in cricket match, ball went straight up with a velocity of 40 meter per second. Calculate maximum height of the ball, time to reach that height. Now here, we cannot use concept formula technique. And you will learn the reason. Let me read it for highlighting the given data. The ball went straight up. It means the ball possesses negative gravitational acceleration g with a velocity of 40 meter per second. It means the initial velocity vi of the ball is 40 meter per second. Now to find maximum height h and time t to reach the height. So we are given four variables in this numerical. I mean gravitational acceleration g, initial velocity vi, height h and time t. Here comes the challenging task which you should learn. Firstly, you must write all the formulas you know which can connect all these four variables at one side of the page. For example, vf is equal to vi plus gt, h is equal to vit plus half of gt square, and 2gh is equal to vf squared minus vi squared. Now look at the first equation. Vf is equal to vi plus gt. There are four values and it. Vf, vi, g and t. While in the numerical, we have also g as in the equation, vi as in the equation, t as in the equation. But here we do not have vf in the numerical as we have it in the equation. In this case, read the numerical once again to look for the value of vf. In case you do not find the value of vf in numerical, then we will skip using this equation for this numerical. Let me read it. In cricket match, ball went straight up with a velocity of 40 meter per second. Calculate maximum height of the ball. Here is the final velocity. Remember that when ball reaches or gains maximum height, its final velocity vf becomes zero. Now all these four variables given in the numericals matches all these four variables and the equation. So check this equation, we can use it. The second step is that how can we use it? Just look among these four variables. The one which is required can be calculated using this equation. For example, time t is equal to unknown, while all the remaining variables and the numericals are given. For example, vf is equal to 0 meter per second, vi is equal to 40 meter per second, g is equal to minus 9.8 meter per second squared. So we find one key for this lock through brute force technique. Now I will instantly apply this key on this lock. Vf is equal to vi plus gt. Here the g is negative. Hence vf is equal to vi minus gt. We have to find the time t. Now rearranging this equation, t is equal to vf minus vi upon minus g. Now plug in all the values and this equation. T is equal to 0 meter per second minus 40 meter per second upon minus 10 meter per second square. Because here the value of G is round about 10 meter per second square. As a result, we get 4 second. So ball takes time T is equal to 4 second to reach maximum height. Now the second required variable in this numerical is maximum height H, which the ball will reach. Again we will search for the key among these equations. Now look at this equation. H is equal to VIT plus half of GT square. Here in the numerical, VI is given. So it is also present in this equation. T in the numerical is also present in this equation. G in the numerical is also present in this equation. While height H in this numerical is also present in this equation. Hence all the variables of the numerical is present in this equation. So we can use this equation or this key for this log. Now write this equation. H is equal to VIT plus half of GT square. Secondly, what is required? We know that H is required. Hence H is already the subject of this equation. So simply put values in this equation. H is equal to VI is 40 meter per second into time, which is 4 second, plus half of G is negative, hence minus 10 meter per second square into 4 second squared. As a result, we get H is equal to 80 meter. So this ball gains 80 meter height and time 4 second. F thrown with initial velocity 40 meter per second. This was all about how to solve any physics problem easily. If you have learned something new, then like this video and share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this lecture.